Tower Heroes is a tower defense game made on Roblox. In the game, you can place heroes or towers to stop hordes of enemies from attacking your base. In the past couple of weeks, I really fell in love with the game and has played it every day. But like every game that you start to love, the more you love it, the more flaws and things you would like to improve you find in the game. Hello everybody and welcome back to a brand new video. In this video I will go over a couple of annoyances and things I would like to see improved in Tower Heroes. For all the IDs I have made a little visualization in Photoshop to show you guys how it would look like or how it would work. Anyway, let's start off with the first thing I like to see improved. So the first thing that I would like to see improved is to add a difficulty rating to every map. Now I know you can choose between easy, medium and hard, but some maps like the desert are way more easy, like for example the forest or the volcano. I think difficulty stars shown right here would really help new players pick out the map and not get overwhelmed right away. The second thing I want to talk about is private servers. Adding private servers to this game was an absolutely amazing idea. It's really useful for me for when I stream or want to play with a lot of friends that we can just hop on a private server. There is a problem though. When you finish a map, it sends you back to a public server. Now a lot of games have this issue and I understand that it's not easy to fix, but I would really appreciate it if the developers took another look at it and see how they maybe can improve this feature. Because having to leave the public server to re-enter your private server after every match can get quite tedious and annoying. For my third suggestion, I would suggest that we can click on other people's towers. Now don't get me wrong, we don't need to upgrade other people's towers, but it's really nice to see the stats and even the range of the other person's tower. Right here you can see my Voka and you can see all the stats because it's mine. But when I click on my friend's Voka, I get no information. This can be quite annoying for new players and even for veterans to figure out if their units are in range of Spectre or other units. Another thing that I would like to see in the game is something that I also have suggested in one of my other videos, and that is to add a speed and volume slider to Spectre. I have made a little visualization of where the button for the volume slider and speed slider can be, but I think this can be a really nice addition to the Spectre custom game pass to make it absolutely perfect. Some songs on Roblox are uploaded at half speed to prevent the copyright issue, so I could understand if they didn't want to add a speed up function to not get in any trouble. But a volume slider on the other hand is quite necessary. Some songs are so much louder than others and having us tweak it all to make the perfect Spectre would be awesome. And now we unfortunately arrive at the one ID I don't really have an ID on how to fix. But when you have a lot of towers together and you want to upgrade one that's right in the middle, it's super hard to click on that tower to upgrade. Maybe you can make a special keybind on your keyboard that turns every tower in like a picture on the ground, so you can upgrade it easily and then switch back to the tower mode. I have no idea how that would work and if it's even worth all the effort, but it might be something to keep in mind to make clicking on towers that are hidden inside other towers a lot more easy, because it can be quite a bit of a pain. When I first started to play the game, I thought that the HP bar at the top was of the final boss. Of course I learned later that it's the HP bar of your own tower. But it got me thinking, why when the final boss spawns do we not see a giant epic health bar at the top of our screen? I made this little visualization of what it could look like and I think it can be pretty useful. Once again, for new players, they know that, oh my god, this is the really bad guy that we gotta kill. And for veterans, it might be useful to see how much HP the boss actually has, because sometimes there are so many towers and attacks in the way, it is quite difficult to see the HP of the boss. And the suggestion that I want the most is skin previewing for higher levels than level 1. I made this little visualization of how it would work, where you got these 5 buttons under the character, which when you click on them, switch to 1 only 5 levels. So when you acquire a new skin, for example the Lemon Girl, you can see what the final tower looks like from your inventory and not have to go to a match on easy just to see if you even like the skin. I really hope this suggestion makes it in the game, because it doesn't seem so hard to implement. And the final suggestion, and probably the most important suggestion of them all, please add a Rem skin for Voka. Please just add it, and if you don't like to add Rem, please add Alice or Yuki from Sword Art Online. Thank you. Anyway guys, thank you all so much for listening to my suggestions. I really hope some of my more serious suggestions get added into the game, especially the skin preview. I would absolutely love that. Don't forget to join my Discord in the link in the description. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye! Please give me that Voka skin.